Hey there, handsome.
Hi there.
Joe ain't here right now. He said for you to meet him for lunch at Freddy's.
I see.
Too bad you were passed out when I came in. We could have partied. Maybe next time, doll. Bye.
Huh. That was something.
You belong.
Hey, isn't that Joe's girl over there? Well, one of them anyway.
You smacked up my car, I'm gonna smack up yours. Look at my fucking car!
Hey, pal, knock it off.
And who the fuck are you?
Somebody who doesn't like hearing you talk to a lady like that. So why don't you shut the fuck up and leave while I'm still in a good mood, huh?
What, is she your girlfriend or something? Well, if she's not gonna pay for it, you will.
One more word, and you're gonna need a new set of teeth. Now get the fuck out of here. That was the word.
Thanks, handsome. I owe you one. Do you want to come over to my place for a piece of pie?
Yeah, thanks, but look, I really gotta get going.
You'll like it, I promise. I gotta get going now. I'll see you around.
Forces have completely encircled the sprawling city and are now facing a Japanese occupation force estimated to be 20,000 strong. Early reports have already indicated that this could be one of the bloodiest battles yet seen in the Pacific. More on this story as the information comes in, and hopefully, the Japanese are pushed out of Manila. For Press Radio News, I'm Lowell Harris.
Hey, fellas.
Hey. Hey, Vito, this is Luca Garino. He'd like to talk to you and Joe. Luca, this is Vito.
Good to meet you, Mr. Garino.
No need to be so formal. Call me Luca. Take a seat, Vito.
What can I get you?
Same thing I'm having. And I read up. I heard about you running with the mix. Great fucking story. And I want to congratulate you, too, on a job well done. Salute.
A salute.
You guys did a hell of a job. Not too many guys got the stomach for this line of work. So now, I'm wondering if yous are ready to take the next step.
Yeah, sure. What next step?
I'm talking about taking somebody out. Just because someone points his finger at him and tells you to do it.
I was in the war, Mr. Garino. All I did was kill people I was told to kill. People the president pointed his finger at.
That's good. The president. Yeah, I like that. Yeah. But you're talking about the Krauts, right? You know, the bad guys. That's not what I mean. Understand?
Yeah, I understand.
Good. We need guys like you. Guys who can follow orders without asking questions. You handle this next job like you handled the last one, and there's a good chance you'll be accepted into the family. After you pay the initiation fee, of course.
And how much is that?
$5,000 apiece.
That's a fucking fortune.
Hey, nobody said it was cheap, huh? But trust me, the benefits far outweigh the cost. I'll leave it up to you two to decide. Henry's gonna fill you in on the rest. I'll see his guys later.
There you are.
Hey, your boss.
You take care of that thing we talked about yet?
Yeah, yeah, it's all under control.
That's Henry's what you said the last time. Don't disappoint me again.
Boss,
Now come with me. We got some other business to discuss.
So, Henry, what kind of job we talking about here?
I gotta take a guy out. It's my contract, but thanks. I need some help. That's where you two come in.
Who's the lucky guy?
Some fat fuck from across the river. The guy's been warned, but he thinks he's untouchable.
Huh. And is he?
Well, somebody tried to take him out once before.
And?
Let's just say they slightly underestimated him.
How much is slightly?
Fatally.
That's a fancy way of saying they're dead, right?
Hey, they fucked up. We won't. I rented an apartment across the street from his business. We'll sit there, and we'll wait till that fat fuck shows up, and then boom! We blast his ass.
How are we gonna do that?
With an MG-42.
Where are we getting an MG-42 from?
Harry.
Yeah.
He's a vet, like you. He's got a private little gun shop over in Kingston. We could get you anything from a pea shooter to a bazooka. And you don't need no fucking gun license, neither.
Okay, Joe and me will go to the apartment. You go pick up the machine gun at Harry's shop in Kingston. It's all paid for. Just tell him I sent you. After that, meet us at the apartment. It's in Sand Island. The building across from the distillery. Apartment 233.
Okay, apartment 233. Got it. I'll meet you fellas there in a bit.
All right, see you later.
Good luck, pal.
What would you like?
One brewski coming up. Enjoy.
There's gonna be a hallelujah day when the boys have all come home to stay and the million bands begin.
Henry Tomasino sent me to pick up the stuff he ordered.
Come on in.
Hello?
So, you're the guy Henry was telling me about, huh?
Yeah. You got his merchandise.
Yeah, well, here it is. MG-42, made in Germany. Hitler's buzzsaw, we call them. She's a beauty. 25 pounds. 7.92 caliber. 1,200 rounds per minute. Fastest in the world. 250-round belt, 3/4 mile effective range, and extremely reliable. I don't know what the hell you're hunting, but unless it's in a fucking tank, sayonara, baby. Hey, you need me to show you how to use it?
No, thanks. I'm familiar with him. I was in the service, too.
No shit! Wait, you're kidding me. Where were you? What was it, Normandy, huh? No, Africa? All right, let me guess.
Operation Husky.
Yeah? What unit were you in?
504th Parachute.
No shit, you were a paratrooper? That was kind of hairy, I heard.
Yeah, well, it wasn't no picnic, I tell you. I got hit, so they sent me home.
Yeah, any medals?
Yeah, Purple Heart and a DSC.
Whoa, wait, you got a cross? Let me tell you, they don't give those babies out for nothing. I was in Normandy. We hit Utah Beach. Yeah, that wasn't no picnic neither, but... When I was crawling over the fence on the way back, I poked my eye out on a fucking tree branch. Well, hey, it was good enough for a discharge.
Look, guy, I really gotta get going.
All right. Hey, by the way, I'm Harry.
Hey, Vito.
Hey, good to meet you, Vito. Real good. If you ever need some hardware, you know where to find me. There you go. I hope you drove here. She's a big girl. Good luck.
Hey, thanks. Nice to meet you, Harry.
The gun's in the crate, and there's a couple thousand rounds in the van out in the yard. Take it. It's all paid for. Devastation on the Nazi headquarters and surrounding buildings in Berlin just 1 week ago. So what do you need, Vito? Show of strength. Almost 1,000 B-17 flying fortresses blanketed the... Like my mom always said, you can never have too much ammo. Like my mom always said, you can never have too much ammo. Allied hands within the coming weeks. For Press Radio News, I'm Lowell Harris.